So we have quite a few interesting talks and presentations here. The first one is a talk on OSM for disaster management. Ideally, each of the presenters will be given 15 minutes to present, and there will be a 5-minute question and answer session. We can probably take like 2-3 quick questions. Saikat will be showing you how much more minutes are left so that you can have a track of time. Moving on to the first talk, which is on OSM for disaster management by Mr. Harry. A little about Harry. Harry loves geography and traveling. Since he studies geography at university, he uses his knowledge to make some simple analysis and interpretation about objects that he sees. He's a part of humanitarian OpenStreetMap team and looks to make map making easier and more accessible to people. He's here to talk about the role of OSM in disaster management in Indonesia. Over to you, Harry.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Harry from Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team. I have a talk about the OSM for disaster management citywide mapping project. So yeah, let's get started. The outline for this presentation, there is a 5 outlines that I will present to you today. So yeah, the first one is what? So like a general idea of what this is project is all about. And the second outline is when we do the mapping in 3 cities in Indonesia for this topic, and how we can do the mapping project, the methodology, and the how way we work. And the 4th outline, it's the result, how many buildings we collected, the output of this project, and the use for disaster management. And the last outline is a challenge, and listen, learn that we can try to fix it in the future. So what? This project is a joint program with the PDC from the US and the National Disaster Management Agency in Indonesia and the Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team to support management tools and data for Indonesia. The question is how we can support disaster management tools and data in Indonesia. The answer is by provide update and accurate lifeline infrastructure and associated information in OpenStreetMap for the city of Surabaya, Jakarta, and Semarang. And then for the mapping object, basically we mapping all the infrastructure in the 3 cities, started from the banks until the administration boundary. And we not only map the name of the object or the location of the object, but we also collected the essential information that we can use for disaster management activities, such as the building condition. It's really still can be used as evacuation center if disaster happen, building levels, so how tall the buildings, and then the building type or building roof, such as for event of the earthquake, and another object, inside a physical object, we also map the natural objects, such as river or reservoir in the area as a resource for disaster management activities. And also green fields, because in Indonesia, when disaster happened, mostly people evacuated in the green fields or green spaces, so we have to collect those objects as well. So when the project has started, so it's begin in Surabaya, started in October 2016 until February 2017. And after Surabaya, we moved to the capital city of Indonesia, it's Jakarta. It started in March until November 2017. And the last city is Semarang. It started January and just finished in July this year. So we have a, why this city it's being mapped, because in this is the big 3 cities in Java and Indonesia. And this city has a common problem, disaster, which is flood. So that's why we choose the city. And we have a, how we can do maps, we divide it into three different states of activities. The first stage, it's pre-mapping activities. So yeah, the first thing that we do is, before started the mapping, is to doing initial mapping with the local disaster management agency. Because there is two reason we start the initial meeting. First, to get the surveying permit letter. As you know, in Indonesia, we map using a hot name, it's not really welcome if we don't involve the local government. Sometimes we only see as an international organization who has a hidden agenda behind our project. So that's why the survey permit letter from the local disaster management is really important for our team to do the field mapping. And the second one is to really need to know what's the object they really need to map in the area. For example, each city has a different priority, depends on the evacuation activities. For example, in Jakarta, when the flood happens, only big mosque will be used as an evacuation shelter. But in Semarang, even the small mosque, it's also being used as an evacuation center. So those objects, it's really different in each city. So we really need to know what the government really need to know in their area before we started the mapping. The second activities is building a community. So yeah, we hire local people because they really know about the area. So our mapping survey is more efficient. They never get lost when they doing survey mapping. Instead, we just take people from Jakarta or only from HOT. We lost when we do survey. So instead, we hire local people. And the second activity is we contact the local university. Like I said in the country panel, this is our aim to make sure the sustainability after the project. So we contact them and we create the local mapathon. Local mapathon, it's for like disseminate the OpenStreetMap and also to involve the students in this project, at least for the complete the building footprint. So our team in the field not digitized but only collected the information. And the third, it's mapping equipment. We do the prepare the survey map for each village before we survey, and we got the satellite imagery from the USID. So it helped us to get the clear imagery before we start digital. So this is the mapping team structure. For Surabaya and Semarang, we have a two mapping supervisor. Responsibility is to supervise the whole mapping activities. And for quality assurance, the general responsibility is to like control the information, the topology of the data. And the 16 data entry, or we can call the field map. So these people who coming to the field and collected those information. And Jakarta, it's because it's still more bigger than the rest. So we have still two mapping supervisor, but we have a 5 quality assurance and data entries because the size of the area and the number of the data. The mapping strategies, we create a small and solid group. So each group only consisted 2 people. And because the less number of the group people in the group, it's more less drama because less head, less problem, less confrontation. So we make it clear. And other reason is because we can spread a lot of people in a lot of area at the same time. It's more saving the time. And the second strategy is regionalize the cities. So yeah, because we have a 2 mapping supervisor, it's a scene mapping structure. So each mapping supervisor will focus on each zone. For example, in Surabaya, we divide a north and south area. So one mapping supervisor will focus on the north area, and the others will focus on the south. It's more effective to maintain the quality of the data. And the third, this is really important, the regular team evaluation. Every week and each month, we have a regular meeting evaluation from the small team until the whole team to make sure what the problem that we face in the field and make sure the problem is not really repeated in the next month. So this is really important to keep your team solid and do not making same mistake every time. And the fourth, we don't use a conventional GPS. We use a open data kit and open map kit application in Android. So it's like an application that can provide you collecting data without have to print a lot of paper, wasting paper, and just put it in the paper. So we just using a smartphone application. So it's saving time, and the result of the survey, it's directly exported to the OpenStreetMap format. So it's saving our time instead of we exported the GPX file to SAP and exported to the OpenStreetMap. So this is a little bit animation. So yeah, this is our team, started from the office. using motorcycle, because in Jakarta and the other city you can use car to survey. You will get stuck, so we get motorbike or motorcycle. And the first stop is the village office. The village office is to get, like I said, surveying permit letter, and to update the boundary administrative, to get the update. So in the city, the administration boundary, it's already collected from the village representative. And after that, they filled in this area for like a 2 or 3 days, collecting all the objects that the local government needs. And after that, like I said, using Open Data Collect and Open Map Kit, they went back to the office. Yes, and after that, they input the data on the OpenStreetMap, and after input the data, we exported the data and created the printed maps. The printed maps, it's like each village will get another printed map. So they already gave us the data, we bring back the data for them as a printed map, so like a good map. The post-mapping activities to make sure this is still sustainable, creating thematic atlas for each city. So we create those fillets, we compile to one big books and created for each city, so we have a 3 atlas. And the second activities is workshop for the local disaster management agency to transfer the knowledge, like I said, to make sure they can still help us to preserve the quality of the data in those cities. And the third one, making training modules and documentation. The result, but I can tell you that we mapped 3 big cities in Jakarta, in Indonesia for like 2 years. So we mapped Jakarta in 2 years. And this is the using the OSM visualization as a GIF. You can say, I will share the presentation after this. And this is the sample of the data. This is the survey map before we survey the data. And this is the result. This is a really, really good data for any purposes, especially for disaster management activities. And the data use is used for national, local government, local area, and other organization. For example, for the National Disaster Management Agency, they use it in their tools called InaWARE. So it's like a not public software, only used for national and specific local disaster. This is the product of our mapping is become one of the layer. So it can help to see how big the impact of when disaster happens and using the national. And the local disaster, we created the printed maps, but more thematically. For example, this is the map of hazard distribution in Semarang City. And the lowest level is for the village office and the people who living in the village, like evacuation maps. This is in Semarang and this is in Bukit Duri. So it's really help them to really understand their area better in terms of disaster management. And the fourth is used by other disaster tools. This is a sample for Peta Bencana tools. It's like a social media platform. They use our mapping result as a base map only. So the report will be based on the administrative boundary, sub-village level. The challenge, sometimes we still rejected by people. If that happens, even though we have a surveying permit letter, we ask the local government to accompany us to the field. And area condition, traffic condition, it's really bad in Indonesia, especially in Jakarta. And the weather, because we survey sometimes in the flood, rainy season, so we're using motorbike, so it's not really help. And expected even like a flat tire or hit by car sometimes, but it's not really major hit, just minor. So listen, learn. So the availability of exposure data is really critical in Indonesia. Therefore, this mapping project should be replicated in other cities, especially in disaster-prone area. And the second lesson learned, government and community could and should working together to create good, reliable mass map and to update information. And the third lesson, OpenStreetMap can be very good alternative to gather all information to provide base map for community and government, particularly in disaster management system. And the last lesson, OpenStreetMap can be used in broad scale of disaster management, starting from preparation, mitigation, response, and rehabilitation for all disaster management activities, both in online or offline platform. We can just print the map and give it to the local people. So yeah, still have time to put some videos. So to give you a better understanding about what we do, what we did in this project, I will show you the video in Semarang. We create 3 videos, but this is only for Semarang.
Survei terhadap teman-teman, kemudian mereka memberikan masukan terhadap objek apa yang perlu diletakkan serta kebutuhan mereka.
So yeah, this is the end of my presentation. Hopefully it can give you some insight for using OpenStreetMap for disaster management, and thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, Harry. If we have one quick question, we can probably take it up. Any questions? Do you have any questions? No? Okay, thanks a lot. Just a minute before asking questions. So the next talk is by Gaurav Thapa.
Wanted to say, first of all, great work. This is something that I think other countries should be looking at for disaster relief.
Yes.
Question, maybe I missed this part, but has the government come up with official policies for uptake of OpenStreetMap, looking at such projects?
Yeah, actually, because the local government itself really hard to find the data for make a disaster management plan from the official government, so that's why they find the alternative. So that needs is really aligned with our aim in this project, so that's why it's not really hard to reach them to use the OpenStreetMap data. And as far as I know, in Indonesia, is if the data is used for disaster or any humanitarian project, all the data from all sources can be used. Yes, I think that's
not officially, but there is good,
yes,
informal.
Yes. Not official, but our data, it's really not definitive, but really participative.
Right.
So, yeah.
Yeah, in India, we had an open source related law a long time back, not been used, but there was something in writing.
Yeah, yes. Thank you, then. If you guys, or maybe we can have a personal question. Okay, so if you guys still have a question with me, you can ask me in personal, so because we have another session. Please, thank you and sorry.